When Holst came to compose Uranus, almost 2 years had elapsed since he'd started and finished Mars. And by this time, he started to include other influences. It's quite clear that this is a sort of companion piece to Dukas, the Sorcerer's Apprentice. And it has the sort of gobbling bassoons that go all the way through it. In a sense, it's like a sort of lumpen second scherzo. It kind of galumps its way through the whole piece. And it's almost a kind of comic piece. I don't think that probably has anything at all to the original planet, and perhaps not even to the astrological sign that goes with it, but much more to the contrast that Holst was building into the suite. So the movement, as it were, represent another emotion, another idea, which is going into the piece.
Uranus is the most boring of all the planets. I find it very, very nothing. It's about 15 times bigger than the Earth. It's a gas giant. It's covered in clouds. Nothing much ever happens there. And I think that's really all we can say. We've been there. When I say we've been there, space probes have been there, but haven't found anything terribly exciting. Like all the outer planets, it's got a set of rings going around it, but they're fairly thin. And it's got a few moons, one of which has been fairly cracked up, actually. It's been Mimas has been impacted so much. It's got a great big crater, like a big eye in the middle of it. It just about fell apart. But apart from that, no, I'm not a fan of Uranus.